How's it going, guys? Drae here, and today I am really excited because we're going to be checking out Megaquarium. Or is it Megaquarium? Not really sure. But yes, this is an Aquarium Tycoon game that's going to be coming out on September the 13th. And if you don't know, in real life, my third passion behind YouTube and gaming is aquariums. I've had them for quite a few years now, and my worst, I had 5 aquariums at once. Currently, I have 1 180-gallon. So, being that this is an aquarium game, I'm really excited because this is another passion of mine. So we're going to be checking it out today. Obviously, I'll probably really enjoy it, but if you guys like it, we'll definitely be doing some more. Now, in this game, you start off with a very basic aquarium, and as you level up, you unlock new pieces to get bigger and better aquariums. So we're going to be doing the campaign. We'll have a normal difficulty, and I have played this a little bit. I gotta say, it's nice and relaxing. It's pretty chill. And yeah, I'm excited to see where it goes. So welcome to Sunnyside, ladies and gentlemen. We've been tasked with building a small aquarium from scratch here at Sunnyside. Before investors release any funding, they want to make sure you can handle the basic controls, yada, yada, yada. We got to do a tutorial. So we're going to do that real quick. We're going to waste no time and try and get this done as quickly as possible. Now the boring stuff's out of the way. We can actually start building our aquarium. So great stuff. You just unlocked your first round of building your aquarium. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to try and plan ahead a little bit. I want to, how much money do we got? We got 2,000 buckaronis right now. We're going to expand out our aquarium a little bit to add some more floor space. Does that use a lot of money? Okay, that did use quite a bit of money. So I have some plans in place that I want to do later on, because like I said, I did play a little bit, so I know kind of like the layout strategy that I want. But for right now, I do not have the money to do that, so we're just going to build a basic tank. We can always move these when we do need to anyways. We actually need to build 2 basic tanks, so I'm going to throw these guys right over here like so, and we need some space in between because these things need water heaters and filters. All right, so basic filter, there we go, basic filter and basic heater, there you go, there you go. So now we have the temps correct. These things are going to be probably tropical tanks. Yes, the tropical tank requires 18 heat, whatever the heat. Oh, sorry, it needs 8 heat. We're currently at 18, so rather small tank for the size heater that we got, but that doesn't really matter. Well, it does in real life. You definitely don't want to overheat your tank. You'll kill your damn animals, but in this game, the metric doesn't matter. We need some azure demoiselles in these tanks. Add some decorations to your tank. So they want 2 tanks of azure demoiselles. So that's the current only fish that we have, so we can throw... Let's just throw... Do we need more than 2? No, okay, so we only need 2 for right now. We can maybe throw different species in there later. Now, obviously, fish need decorations or, you know, it's kind of mean to keep them in a glass box. So here you guys go, have some rocks. Enjoy them. Let's add some sea lettuce as well. And we need food for these guys. So we'll move this stuff around for right now. We're just going to have this quickly placed. And as we start unlocking more, we will definitely move these things around. But we need a tool station. This is for repairs if our heaters or anything goes. And food station was in there as well. The orange pellets, we'll put these nice and close to the aquarium so we can do them quickly. Now we need to hire an aquarist and open the aquarium. So if we go in here, we have, it looks like 2 employees we can choose from, Harry or Anna. Stats are pretty close, as well as the cost per day, $17 and $16. We are not very good bosses if we're paying our people $16 or $17 a day. So yeah, I'm not even going to look at the talents because they're so similar. Let's see what they're going. Let's see what's going on with them. Harry used to work in an aquarium shop, so is familiar with the basics of keeping an aquarium running. Well, that's good to know. And Anna cut her teeth on the hobby tanks at home, so she likes to keep things small scale. So being that Harry has actual experience in aquarium, we're going to hire him for right now. We'll probably end up hiring Anna later on anyways. All right, and let's open it up, and here we go. Well done, your basic aquarium is up and running and your first guest has arrived. Whenever a guest enters your aquarium, they'll pay some of these dollars to enter, which we can use to buy things. In addition, as they experience your displays, they'll reward you with ecology points, which can be used to unlock new animals for your aquarium. So that's basically your research. All right, so I hope you like this. Oh crap, we got a problem already, as you can see. I didn't notice that. All right, so this is our next fish, the orchid booty back. I read that wrong. It's the orchid dotty back. But you know what? I'm going to call it the orchid booty back because check out that booty on that thing. It's a pretty little fish here. So we're going to start researching that. And yes, as we start getting those ecology points, we will unlock that fish. But we have a problem. I cannot reach this filter here, so we gotta move this guy over on this side because we got our pellet dispenser in the way. Like I said, we're gonna move these aquariums soon anyway, so it doesn't even matter where those are placed. And there we go! The orchid booty back is ready to rock and roll, and we're gonna probably throw him in this tank, or maybe we should build... Oh, it wants me to actually build a large tank, so I guess we'll do that for the old orchid Dottie back. Yeah, it says it wants the orchid booty backs in the new tank, so I guess I can't put them in my old tank. That's all right. I want a bigger tank anyway. So we're gonna go over here, and it looks like that's as big as I can currently make the tanks. Now, do not get this confused. These are not the only tanks that are in the game. There's, like, whole walled tanks. There's actually platform tanks. So it looks like this game is pretty damn impressive. Did you know you can move your animals and direct aerations in between? Yes, I did. We'll get onto that when we do need to, but I don't need to right now. Anyway, so yeah, that's the biggest tank we can currently have, but like I said, we can have whole wall tanks, and I'm really excited when we get to that area. Let's kind of stock or hardscape this tank, meaning we're going to add some decorations here, so we don't have too much at our disposal right now, so it's slim pickings for these guys, but there you go. Keep them a little bit happy, and let's actually see what the Dottie back needs. So it wants... 3 ecology points, so I think actually if we go into here, the only thing that gives ecology points is the sea lettuce, so we're gonna actually need 3 of those in there to keep those guys happy. Alright, so sorry, I did that mistake. That's the ecology points we get whenever the guest views this thing, so we actually didn't need that much sea lettuce, but I did it anyways. And it wants 6 in this tank. Okay, hopefully we don't overstock this tank. No, actually, we've still got more than enough room in this tank. What the hell? Uh-oh. Orchard Dottie back is at risk of death because care requirements. Oh, crap! I forgot to put a filter on. That is what you don't want to do as an aquarist. I am not planning out very well here. Sorry, guys. More specifically, sorry to the fish. They should be okay. We just ran the risk of death there. Small mistake, but we're good. You may have noticed a set of icons attached to each animal. Yes, I did. These are known as animal care requirements. Failure to meet these will reduce health of your animals or could lead to death, which we've already almost experienced. Your visitors have arranged for you to access a new fish. My investors. New fish called Half and Half Chromis. Let's take a look at the care requirements. Yada, yada, yada. Encounter before. It's a shoaler. Okay, so a shoaler is a fish that's a schooler. Meaning it needs multiple fish for it to be non-stress. So basically it's a wimpy fish that needs a species of it around it to feel safe. So yeah, it needs a minimum of 4 for this fish, it looks like. And yeah, so we just have to make sure we keep the fish happy, obviously. So yeah, we now have a shoaler that we got to deal with. So can we put these guys anywhere? Now we have 6 points available in this tank before it's overstocked. Now, each fish is going to take 3, so I need at least 4 of these guys, so obviously we need 12 points, so we're gonna need a whole new tank, and with that, we may as well design one anyways. We're earning lots of money, so no harm done by building another big tank here. Oh, that's a problem, though, because we're not gonna be able to get in there, so what we're gonna wanna do is just move this over one for right now. Actually, now that we have some money, we can probably do what I want, but I'm gonna wait for an unlock that I need, so... yeah, I plan on moving all these tanks around. This is just temporary until I unlock some stuff. So, let's get some more filtration on this and not screw up like last time. So these guys are shoalers, so we need 4, and I'm currently only gonna do 4 because I don't wanna overstock these tanks. Alright, there we go. Now you have got a few different species of fish in your aquarium, you should be able to rank up soon. Ranking up will instantly unlock new equipment, decorations, and facilities, and increase the repertoire of animals which are available to research. So yes, there's a ranking system in this game. It's actually pretty cool. There's more. The higher your rank, the more guests you attract, and the more they are willing to pay to enter your aquarium. So basically, our rank is our prestige. Ranking up occurs as a result of generating prestige, and that's actually what it's called. Interesting. These are earned whenever a guest enjoys something in your aquarium. So basically, keep our guests happy, we earn prestige, and we rank up. Got it. Good to know. And look at that! We actually ranked up already, and what did we unlock with prestige rank 2? We got Driftwood Caves for our tank, the Combi Mini, which is what I was patiently waiting for. This is a filter and heater all in one, and we have a staff door, which is what I also wanted, so obviously staff can only go there. So that actually reminds me, we should probably hire some more staff. We're getting quite a bit of aquariums going on, and we have some money, so we may as well do it. Let's unlock some more animals. Okay, so we're going to unlock the King Demoiselle. which we'll start working on now. And I'm going to actually pause the game because I want to start working on this now and expanding out a little bit. So all our build stuff is over here. We can add walls, we can add platforms, and we can add stairs. Platforms, by the way, are to allow our employees to access deep tanks. We don't currently have any deep tanks, so we don't need to worry about that. But what I want to do is expand out. What we're going to do is actually do like a walkway all the way around our aquarium. I think that's going to be pretty smart. Over here, though, we'll add kind of like an employee room. So we'll expand this out a little bit just to add like the workbench and everything here. But also, we're going to go all the way around. Okay, I didn't know if that was dragging or not. But all the way around. And what I'm going to do is put all the hardware away from the viewers, away from the guests, I should say. So how we're gonna do that is basically put the aquariums inside the walls. And I think this will look really, really cool as well. So I'm kind of excited about this. And we'll probably put another staff door over here just so they have multiple entrances. So let's get working on this. I'm gonna kind of keep the layout the same right now. We have a bunch of small aquariums over here and big aquariums over here. So what I wanna do is these big aquariums take 3 pixels on the side. So we're going to expand out by 6 pixels. Oh man, I crack myself up sometimes. Yes, we're gonna expand out by 6 pixels, guys. And we're going to put the aquariums back inside the actual walls. They can still be viewed from the outside, but this means we can move. Actually, we may as well just change this hardware as well and upgrade to the better hardware. So we're gonna sell all this stuff. It is paused right now, so we do not risk killing our fish. It says we're at risk, but the game's paused, so these guys should be totally fine. At least hopefully. I would feel really bad if I actually killed them right now. But now you can see it's gonna be much more organized back here. And actually, we could even, yeah, you know what? Let's just keep it like this so we don't ruin our walkway here. And now we have this space to put all the hardware that we're going to need. Right now, we just need combi minis. So there we go. Looks like that has everything happy over there. And then obviously all the ugly hardware is hidden from anyone that comes in. So this is going to be a much better layout in my opinion. And I think it will make the residents happy. It will definitely make me happy at least. And we're going to put the workshop back here. The only thing the workshop does, at least currently, to my knowledge, is repair any broken down machinery. What's weird in this game is you don't have to do water changes. If you are an aquarist, you know that water changes are extremely important, so I hope they add them later. But for right now, it looks like we do not have to do water changes to our actual aquariums. All right, and you get the idea. We're going to do the same thing over here. These are smaller aquariums, so we only need 4 blocks, and we'll be able to add lots of aquariums down this wall now because we don't need to add spaces in between these things. So there we go. Once again, get the... I'm probably only going to use the combi mini. It only makes sense. This is a much better filter, so let's keep those guys and keep our fish nice, happy, and healthy. All right, and then if we want to expand the length, all we got to do is expand the walkway as well. Let's actually add one more staff door. Yeah, you know what? We'll just add it right here like so. And I guess technically I need to open this up too, or they're just kind of walking into a wall. So expand that out. There we go. And I gotta say, that looks a hell of a lot better. I might even bring the workbench out here just to be closer. We'll see how often they have to repair these things. I honestly have no idea. But there we go. Looks like everything's good. They're still being fed. Everybody's happy. And can we actually show the walls? I know, organize windows. Organize windows. Oh, like all the windows we have on the screen. But yeah, we can toggle the walls. Actually, amazingly, that didn't change anything. So I'm not really sure if that's in being implemented, but it looks like the walls are being toggled anyways. I kind of like the layout that it has right now. These are walls. It's not just basically a counter. All right, so the next fish is the King Demoiselle. So we kind of have to follow which fish it wants us to do. Oh, we're actually waiting for that fish to be unlocked. So right now, we're kind of just hanging out, making sure everything's okay. Let's actually check our parameters here. So requires water quality of 50%. Now, like I said, we can't do water changes. My mind is an aquarist mind. If the water quality is bad, you do a water change, but not in this game. It just basically means you need more filtration. So this water quality definitely isn't great, but it's within the parameters of the current fish in the tank. As you can see, this one's extremely close as well. So basically, we're not overstocking the tank, but we're basically maxing it out. And I just remembered I didn't actually put any decorations in this tank, and we got new decorations as well. So let's actually add these to the tanks. This is going to make people more happy too. It makes the aquariums look better. You can actually rotate this stuff too, which is pretty damn cool. And yeah, may as well add these to make the fish a little bit more entertained. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna have this tank just totally half and half. So we're gonna throw another guy on there, And I'll throw another one as well. We got new animals unlocked by doing that. Now, this might run the risk of making the water quality too poor. And yes, as you can see, it does. So what I'm going to do is put another combi mini in the back, and then the water quality should be great. And yes, indeed it is. Now, the one thing I didn't know about is heating. I was worried that I could overheat these tanks with these filters, because every filter has a heater on it. And the more heaters you have, the hotter the water gets. But I guess with this game, you just have to get the heat above this level. So you need 18 heat. We're at 36 heat. So in real life, if we were heating the tank this much, these fish would be freaking dead. But in this game, you just have to have at least that much heat, and you can definitely go over if you do want to. So now we know that. Now this King Demoiselle is a wimp. So we're gonna get aggressive fish later. We have to remember that he cannot be with aggressive fish. Let's actually, what are the requirements of this fish? Because I might throw him in here. He's a 2 size, so he can definitely go in these little tanks. And I think I might put him in with these guys, which are the Azir Demoiselles. Looks like similar water qualities are needed. Eats the orange pellets, so it eats the same food, so that's good. And it looks like it would definitely fit in that tank. So I'm going to actually put... we're going to stock these tanks with a couple of these, actually. They're expensive, man. And we got an Arabian Blue Line booty bag. Yeah! Now, is he also a wimp? Oh, no, he's a bully! So I was just talking about a wimp fish. This is one of the fish that would pester a wimp fish. So we definitely don't want that in the tank that I'm working on right now. Oh, I have to choose that. Okay, so yeah, we want to research that guy, obviously, because that's our next fish. All right, but King Demoiselle, we're going to stock both of these tanks with 2 of those as well. Let's put some driftwood in this just to make these guys a little bit more happy. There you guys go. And looks like we're doing rather good. We got lots of people coming in. Our fish seem happy. Okay, but these guys don't got driftwood. We should put driftwood in every tank. Keep everybody nice and happy. Can we stack these? Oh, no, we can't. That's too bad. All right, but yeah, we got lots of people. Day 5, and we already got 3 tanks. Or, sorry, 4 tanks set up. We're doing pretty good. All right, so we need the Arabian Blue Line Dotty back now. That actually... Is this a dotty back? Which ones are... This one's the dotty back over here. Okay, I got too many windows open here. I like that you can have multiple windows open. That's really nice, though. So this actually is not fully stocked, so I can probably put the other booty back on this, because this is also a dotty back species. So if we can keep these guys together, that would be great. Now, I'm still waiting for him to unlock, but I'm going to make sure the parameters are similar. And if we can put the guy in there, we're golden. We don't have to put up another tank. Now, do we have any more employees? Oh, yeah, that's right. We didn't even hire... Am I currently... Oh, we have a new guy here. Okay, interesting. I currently only have 1 employee right now. Should probably get another one. He seems to be busy constantly. So, yeah, let's... Might even hire 2 here just because we're earning so much money. So Wade is a bright marine biologist graduate who can learn to work equally well with machines and animals. That actually sounds like a great employee. My question is, if you're a friggin' marine biologist, why are you working for $16 a day? Oh, we just must have got our first broken equipment. That's going to be fixed with a workbench. Yes, as you can see, this one's broken. So hopefully they focus on that. Well, we're definitely gonna hire Wade because Wade is a friggin' marine biologist and he should be really good at doing this. New animal unlocked. There we go. We got the new booty back for the booty back tank over here. Assuming it can fit. Let's just make sure. So we have this one here and this one here. Parameters are exactly the same. It is a bully, but this is not a wimp fish. So I think we're okay. It's the same breed as well or species. So we should be good to have this guy in here. I'm only going to throw 1 on there because it's a bully and I don't want to risk it eating the rest of my fish. We'll keep an eye on him. And he's a much bigger fish as you can see as well. So yeah, all these views, by the way, you can see all these things here. It looks like we're having orange pellet issues. What the hell? Do we have to, like, restock this? 150 out of 200. I'll have to keep an eye on that. Looks like he's just trying to keep up with all the fish. You know what? I think we're going to need a third hiree because, yeah, these guys are running around like chickens with their heads cut off. So I'd rather keep my fish safe if I have enough money to do so. We can actually, if we click these guys, you can give them rolls as well. Oh, you can even fire them, but you can give them zones as well. So once we get to a bigger aquarium standard, obviously that's going to be extremely useful so we can have employees in unique zones. For a simple little tycoon game, this is damn impressive so far. I'm having a great time playing it. Oh, I just realized my water quality is crap over here because we expanded it out. So and before these fish have problems, let's throw another filter on that, and these guys should be fine for a long time now. All right, next up is the yellow tang, the relation of Dory the blue tang. So we're going to start researching that and get a yellow tang up. That sounds absolutely exciting. I'm kind of trying to strategize. Why is this guy walking so slow? This is a shitty employee, man. He is going, why? He's like walking in slow motion. Dude, what are you doing? There's a door right here for this reason. Oh my God. Okay, this guy's doing the same freaking thing. At least he's walking faster. What the hell's going on with you, dude? Are you okay? Oh God, what are you doing, employees? What are you doing? Do you guys even need to be out here? It looks like everything's okay, so they're doing all right. Why is this guy walking so slow, though? This is really frustrating me. All right, well, as long as they do their job, I don't care, but that was really weird. Maybe we should expand out the hallway. Was he, like, dragging on the walls or something? I don't know. All right, looking at prestige rank, there's actually a guest thoughts menu. I just want to see what people are thinking about. I really like that small rocks. Three guests thought that. Wow. It's rocks, guys. You don't have to freak out. I really like that sea lettuce. Who goes to a friggin' aquarium and likes the sea lettuce? Well, they seem to be extremely supportive. The most are liking the king demoiselles as well as azir demoiselles. So, seems like they like that fish. So, we do want to cater to those. Oh, we have the tangs now. So, oh, this one eats green pellets. What else do we need? Oh, it's a plant lover, so it needs at least one plant. Okay, so this is when it's going to get cool, when specific fish like specific aquascapes. And it also needs cleaner water, so yeah, blue tangs are going to be a little bit harder to deal with, but we should be okay to do so. So let's do another big tank right beside these ones. And again, this is just a temporary layout. I want to add more detail to this aquarium later, but for right now, I just want sheer volume. So this is the easiest way to get tanks in here really, really quickly, is to just do a nice line of them. Anyways, let's also add some openings here and get this tank all set up. All right, so we know it likes plants. Unfortunately, we have a very limited selection of plants right now. We have sea lettuce for these guys. So there you go. Enjoy all the sea lettuce you could dream of. At least for a little fish, probably three sea lettuces is a lot. We're gonna put some rocks, and just to make them happy, it's always smart to have a cave so they can hide. We're gonna do a driftwood cave. And that should be ready for tangs. So how many can we put in here? Okay, tangs are rather expensive. Oh crap, that's right, we need a feeding thing for it as well. Oh, we have the black soldier fish. Okay, so gonna keep moving on. This game's all about unlocking all the fish. So green pellet dispenser, we'll throw, where's the other dispenser? All right, that's over there. I'm gonna put the green one right here. Kind of in a pointless spot considering it needs to go all the way over here. But for right now, organization is not key. I'm just all about laying down the tank. So yellow tang, yellow tang, yellow tang. There you go. Water quality's crap. That means we add one more combi mini to this thing, and there you guys should be golden. Hello, little yellow dories. It looks like they're enjoying their new home, and that's obviously good. And they are getting fed now, as you can see with the green food. All right, guys, and I think we did a lot for the first episode. I mean, we started off with nothing, and now we have three tanks, and we just unlocked a black soldier fish. So that's obviously really good. Looks like the fish are going to get progressively more complex. The black bar soldier fish are nocturnal, so they like to have a cave to hang out in when you've reached rank 2 and you've unlocked the driftwood cave decoration, which provides it. So make sure you add one. Also note, they dislike light, so you don't have to worry about this right now, but later we'll have to worry about lighting. That's gonna be when it gets really interesting. I wanna see how they work with plants in this game, because certain plants need certain lighting. But obviously, we don't have to worry about that yet. In the next episode, we'll be working on the black bar soldierfish, and probably working on this layout a little bit. I like it right now, but it feels like a fish store more than an actual aquarium. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed Megaquarium. If you guys do want to see more, obviously let me know in the comments below. And thanks so much for all your support, guys. Thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.